Brooklyn's racetrack might well be described as a war casualty. A new blow has been struck at the hopes of racing enthusiasts. Vickers have bought Brooklyn's and the track will no longer be used for racing. A hangar blocks the course near the start, where once the cars roared away to thrill spectators and keep British racing prestige so high. This is the track itself, which was covered over with scrub and trees for camouflage, and there were canvas houses built on the banking to deceive the German Air Force. Naturally enough, racing enthusiasts don't take very kindly to the new order, and Earl Howe sums up just one aspect, the motor industry's case.
The British public as a whole probably looks upon Brooklands as purely a racing track. The public probably doesn't realise that Brooklands is the only place where observed tests of a motor car at high speed can be carried out. For instance, it is possible to send the ordinary production model of any make of car you like to Brooklands and tell the driver to go on around the track for 1, 2, or 3 hours at sustained high speed without taking his foot off. All that is of immense importance to the car manufacturer. The only alternative to Brooklands is to carry out the tests on the public highway, which is obviously undesirable from the point of view of public safety.
A lot of people will share his regret as they think back to the good old days, days when bank holiday meetings were thronged with enthusiasts and our cameras followed the cars round the banking while they jockeyed for the winning position. Today, a similar shot from the same place looks like this. Depressing, isn't it? Now let's dwell again for a moment on things as they were. In future, I suppose the focal point of British racing will be the road track at Dunnington, at present requisitioned by the War Office. No, I'm afraid there's no doubt about it. Brooklands has had it.